Now, seemingly every time I stream, twitch.tv/mtash, every time I stream, people ask me, what are your stats? What are your talents? What are your artifacts? People want to know. And when they see my D-Luke, they go, huh? You've crowned D-Luke twice already? Wait a second. You've crowned both of these abilities and maxed them out? But what they don't know is, most likely today, when I get the boss materials, I'm actually going to fully crown my D-Luke. Now, I want to talk about crowning people and when to use this resource, because it's expensive, okay? 700,000, a ton of books, boss materials, and a crown that you can only get from specific activities? That's scary. You probably don't want to, you know, waste your resources, and I understand that this is a big decision. But I want to talk about when the best time to crown your characters is, who you should be crowning, and if you're being a little bit crazy holding on to these forever, like some people are. But first, a quick word from our sponsor. This video is sponsored by Summoner's War. Are you bored and looking for a new game to grind? Then we need to have a little chat about Summoner's War. Now, if you've been living under a rock and never heard of this game, they're actually celebrating their 7th anniversary. There has never been a better time to jump into Summoner's War. There is a daily login event as well as a special anniversary shop to give you some free stuff, and 100, count it, 100 free summons and a free Nat 5 monster. That is huge. Summoner's War has over 1,000 unique monsters to collect. You can customize your Sky Island, and there are weekly in-game events and dungeons if you want to battle. If you don't want to fight giant dragons, you can also take your teams into the arena and fight other players. So, what are you waiting for? Click the link down below in the comment section or description and download Summoner's War today. This game is free to play, and if you download the game with my link, it would really help me out. So please, click that link down below and try out Summoner's War today. Thanks, and let's get back into the content. Now, I have invested millions of mora crowning these abilities, and I'm about to crown another one. 2 million mora! Just crowning these three abilities, we've got tons of resin for books, we've got boss materials, and if you're looking at the increases here, you know, it's definitely good, you're getting some extra damage here, but at what point should you crown someone and shouldn't you? And I want to give you a couple of examples, because there's some abilities that are more valuable than others. If you look at something like Zhongli, you actually get extra duration on the Petrify when you get more levels in this talent. And so if you want to lock down opponents and they can't move, that's going to be more valuable, right? And it's also going to give you a bunch of damage. I think it goes from like 830% to 900%. So we're getting a pretty big boost in damage. If you look at something like Dominus Lapidus, every time that I level this up, I'm going to be getting more shield, it's going to be getting better scaling, and down the road, one day, I will probably level this up and I will probably crown it. And that's one of the biggest things, is when do you do that? I've got a recommendation for you that I think is going to change your life. People are very scared of wasting crowns. Right now, I've only got, I guess I can't show it there. I've only got one on my account, and I'm not going to be able to get any more until there are new events. So if you're someone that is very scared about wasting crowns, here's what I would do. I would use your crowns on your main DPS characters and supports that you really like, but always hold on to three if you're really, really scared. That way, if a new character comes out that is absolutely cracked, is insane, every YouTuber and person in the game is saying, oh, they're amazing, they're the best, then you have multiple crowns to use on them. Now, it's gonna take a lot of time to get all their boss materials and books and yada, 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 but if you always hold on to three, you can never worry about missing out. But if you're hoarding 4, 5, 6 of these things, maybe 7 with the next event, what are you doing? What are you doing? I'm gonna argue here that using these crowns is really important. Not only are you gonna do more damage, but it's going to pay itself off long term. How, you ask? Smashing content easily. Now, we all know about the Spiral Abyss. Some people are on floor 9, some are on 10, some are on 11, some can't even touch 12 and they'll never touch 12, and some other people, like your boy MTash, can smash this out, get all the stars, and this is a lot of rewards. You're getting Mora, books, experience for your weapons, you're getting artifacts, and on top of that, you're getting more Mora and Primo Gems. The further you can push in, the more rewards you're getting, and that is sweet. Well, if you're one of those players that's sitting at floor 9, or floor 10, maybe even floor 11, if you can push into floor 12, if you can beat some of those floors, you're going to start getting Mora every 2 weeks that you wouldn't have had before. You're going to get more resources, and you're going to get Primo Gems. Those Primo Gems lead to wishes, which technically you could buy Mora from the shop using the Star Glitter or whatever. It's going to lead to more characters and maybe even some better weapons. But pushing into the Spiral Abyss and beating this is going to be one of the best ways to get free resources in the game. It's one of the best sources for Primo Gems every couple of weeks, and not pushing into here is slowing down your account's progress. I have spent weeks and weeks and weeks and weeks and weeks farming for artifacts for different characters, and in the case of Zhongli, I still only have this set here. He's got some good artifacts that have some crit damage and crit rate, but I can't get the pieces I need in this artifact set, this stupid artifact set, to make anything work properly. And so artifacts can be really finicky, they can be really frustrating, you don't get the right ones to drop or the right stats on them, and getting an upgrade is pretty difficult. But a weapon? This is a guarantee. Everyone should be maxing up their weapons. But talents as well. Talents are guaranteed damage, and that's the reason why I've started really focusing on leveling these up on my main DPS characters. I've got a maxed out basic attack on Ganyu for the charged attacks. I've got maxed out ones for Diluc, so he's smashing everything in his path. If you're someone that hasn't used any of your crowns, this could be 20 or 30 or 40% more damage in a particular character. In the case of Diluc, we're getting bonuses here, here, and here. That could be a big boost to your character. If you look at someone like Zhongli, maybe you're dying in the Spiral Abyss. You could lock down the enemies longer, you could get a much bigger shield, and that's just going to make it easier for you to stay alive and hopefully beat that content. Yes, it's expensive, but it is a guaranteed thing that no one can take away from you. And I think that hoarding crowns for too long is a mistake. Yeah, maybe you want to save one or two for that new character that comes out that you fall in love with. But if you have a couple of awesome characters that are highly rated and recommended by people, maybe you've got a Hu Tao, if you've got someone like a Ganyu, don't be afraid to crown them and get those stats up. Even if you have some 4-star characters, maybe with a lot of constellations, it's not a terrible idea to use a crown on them. In fact, with my Xing Qiu, I'm planning on using a crown on not just this ability, but even his E ability down the road. It isn't a priority for me, but at some point in your account, when you've used up most of your wishes that they give you for free, when you've done most of the quests, unless you're spending a bunch of money on this game, this is my cast of characters. I'm not going to get a whole bunch of new characters on my free-to-play account because I just don't have enough wishes coming in. I might get a new 5-star, but by the time that happens and I level them up, I can probably save up a couple of crowns to use on them. If you're playing the game, you've got a couple of 5-stars, you're free to play, use some crowns on your best characters and dominate the Spiral Abyss. Because hoarding them is just free damage that's sitting there. It's free defenses that is sitting there. And I think that it's honestly, it's a waste, right? I know that I've made a bunch of videos, don't waste your resources, you gotta be careful. But if you're pushing into AR-45, AR-50, AR-55, it's time to start using those resources. You have a set account, you've got kind of set characters, and it's not a mistake to get stronger, in my opinion. Now, if you've got some trashy 4-star characters that you don't really use, you know, maybe you don't want to, crown Noelle. She's fine, but maybe you don't want to be throwing a crown at her, or Amber. And maybe you do, because you love her. But as long as you're picking a 5-star, you're probably safe. If you're picking a top-tier 4-star, like a Bennett, like a Xing Qiu, no one's gonna complain and be like, you're an idiot for using that crown. You're just gonna have a strong, awesome character that's gonna get you Primo Gems and other rewards down the road. In my opinion, it's a no-brainer. So That's me, that's my opinion, and I hope you enjoyed. Thank you so much for watching this video. Make sure to subscribe for more. Check out my Twitch stream if you've never done that, and I will see you soon. Bye-bye.